The entire story is actually a funny amalgamation of instances and references, for the narrator has made sure that their mind stays occupied with the story. So it's a nice, interesting story. You will enjoy the story. It has a flow. Unlike the stories which we, unlike the chapters which we have done earlier, like it was your Landscape of the Soul, Discovering Tut, they were all informative only, and there was no story, there was no flow, there were no incidents. But unlike all those stories, this is an interesting chapter. So let's start with it. Akshita, is the screen visible to you, dear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'm starting here with the text. You have to read the black section and then I'm going to give you the explanation. Please start.
Ranga's marriage list. The Ranga, the accountant's son, is one of the rare breed among the village folk who has been to the city to pursue his study. When he returned to his village from the city of Bangalore.
Ankita, thoda sa slow. Ankita, bhago nahi. Be a little slow.
When he returned to his village from the city of Bangalore, the crowds milled around his house to see whether he has changed or not. His idea about marriage are now quite different, or are they? Rare breed, a person or thing with characteristics
that
are...
Wait. That's it. Black section you have to read. Now, Ranga was an accountant's son. He belonged to a village. And when he came back, the story starts when he has come back from the city to the village. So when he came back from the city, the villagers gathered around, because the village people, the village folk, he just wanted to see that after gaining education from city, how the city life has changed him, what impact the city has given upon Ranga's character. So when he returns to his village from the city of Bangalore, so he was in the city of Bangalore. Now he has come back from Bangalore. So the crowds mill around his house. The village people gathered around his house to see whether he has changed or he is still the same. So this is the general perspective where we understand. There is a way people believe that villagers, if they're coming to the cities, that change them. Because the city life is very different from village life. That there are no farms there, no environment. Village environment is not there, where people are very friendly. People are very candid. And people actually, they're very concerned about each other. Even if it is like for the neighbors, they're very concerned about each other. Here in cities, at times we do not even know that who lives next door. We're not even aware, because we're so much busy, so much occupied every time in our own work. We are rushing for our work every time that we do not even bother. But it's not that in villages. So there's a lot of difference in village life and city life. Here we find the difference here. So the people, the villagers gathered around his house when he came back from Bangalore after receiving his education there in Bangalore. And people gathered in a big crowd around his house to see what change the city has brought in Ranga. Let's continue further. Start from this one when you see this title.
When you see this title, some of you may ask, Ranga's marriage. Why not Ranganatha Viva? Or Ranganatha Vijaya. Well, yes, I know. I could have used some other mouth-filling one like Jagannatha Vijaya or Girja Kalyana. But then this is not about Jagannatha victory or Girja's wedding. It's about our own Ranga's marriage, and hence no fancy title. Hoshali is our village. You must have heard of it. No, what a pity. But it is not your fault.
Please continue.
But it is not your fault. There is no mention of it in any geography book. Those sahibs in England writing in English probably do not know that such a place exists, and so make no mention of it. Our own people do forget about it. You know how it is. They are like a flock of sheep. One sheep walks into a pit, the rest blindly follow it. When both the sahibs in England and our own geographer have not referred to it, you cannot expect the poor cartographer to remember to put it on the map, can you? And so there is not even the shadow of our village on any map.
Now this stanza is basically from the viewpoint of the narrator. The narrator expects the readers to be questioning the simplicity of the title Ranga's Marriage. He feels that readers might be thinking of fancier titles like Ranganathan Vivaha, Ranganatha Vijay, or Girija Kalyana. See, basically all the titles you find, they are from South, the languages of South India, basically. And they live in a village called Hoshadi in Mysore. Mysore is a place near close to Bangalore. So they're living in this place, village called Hoshadi. So the author here says that the place, the village Hoshadi, not many people even know the name of this place. The village is not, but he doesn't blame anybody because even the geography books doesn't mention the name. Now, India is a land which is full of villages. The major land of our country is under the rural, the rural people have occupied it, right? They are mainly villages are there in our country. So here, but there's so many villages that which are not even mentioned in the geographical department. So he refers to the people as sheep who blindly follow each other. So he says that nobody knows the name of this village also because it is nowhere mentioned in geography. And as well as one of the reasons here is also that people here are like sheep who blindly follow each other. Means they do not do anything. They do not use their own logic or brain to justify or invent things that they would become popular or they would become famous or their village would become famous. It happens. If somebody wins an Olympic medal, along with his name, from where he belongs, which not just country, which state or which region or which village, that name is also highlighted. So the person, in a way, he brings pride to his village also, to his region also, to his city also, and obviously to his nation also, right? So here the author says that the name of this village is nowhere mentioned in the geography books and nobody knows because people here just follow. They just are blind followers like sheep, just like a sheep moves in crowd without using its own mind or using applying its eyesight. It just moves on in crowd. Similarly, people are just followers and they do nothing to be noticed so that they become popular or the village name becomes popular. At last, he feels that the cartographer is also not to be held responsible. As a result, there is no trace of the village on the map. So cartographer is a person who draws or produces maps. So he says even the cartographer cannot be blamed that he has not shown his village, this village, on the map. Please continue.
Sorry, I started somewhere and then went off in another direction. If the state of my soul is to Bharat Varsha, what the sweet Kari Gadabu is to be a festive me, then Hoshali is to Mysore state. What the filling is to be Kari Gadabu. What I have said is absolutely true. Believe me, I will not object to your questioning it, but I will stick to my opinion. I am not the only one who seeks glowingly of Hoshali. We have a doctor in our place. His name is Gunda Bhatta. He agrees with me. He has been to quite a few places. No, not England. If anyone asked him whether he has been there, he said no, Anya. I have left that to you. Running around like a flea pestered dog is not for me. I have seen a few places in my time too. As a matter of fact, he has seen many.
Okay, now this is a story, see, where we realize that the author of the story is also a resident of the village, right? He also lives in the village. So he is telling a story about his village, but he has not started the story as such. He is telling his own perspectives, his own thoughts about the village, what the people are like. He's giving his casual description. So the story has not yet started. The author is just telling his thoughts. The narrator here feels apologetic for getting carried away and deviating from the topic. He says, okay, my topic is Ranga's marriage, but I'm deviating from the topic here. So he feels apologetic. He then again throws light upon the significance of the village Hoshali. Now he's coming back to the village where they are living. The story, which is based in village Hoshali only. He says that it is just as important as Mysore is to India. Just like Mysore is to India, Karigadabu to a festive meal and filling is to Karigbadu. So he's then talking about the festive meal here and the place here. Thus, he can't highlight its importance anymore. So that is the only popular thing he can tell about the festive meal, and that is what he has highlighted. Not only him, but the doctor named Ganda Bhatta feels the same. So this is general perspective, nothing much to do with this section of the story. Here we find the author is giving his perspectives of the village he is living in. The village is not much popular. What is popular there, right? And then he feels the people of this village have not done much that the village would become very popular. So he cannot blame the people, or he cannot cartographer for that, right? So now he says that I'm starting with this, continuing with the story. The doctor, he says even he feels so that the villagers have, there's nothing much to mention about this village. And he says even the doctor, Ganda Bhatta, he also feels the same. Doctor is also one of the doctors in the same village. So the doctor has been to many places except England. Please note, it is not England. The correct pronunciation is England. Whenever you read a text, take care of the pronunciation part also. The doctor has been to many places except England, but he still lives, but he still loves Hoshali. So doctor has gone to many places except England, but he loves his village, Hoshali. However, an outsider might contest this, but the narrator claims to stick to his opinion of the place. So obviously the person, wherever you live, your native place is obviously is very close to your heart, where you have spent your entire life or where you have spent your childhood days. Such that native place is very close to your heart. No matter at times you would find that there is nothing good here. Like people, there are tourists who come to Delhi. Delhi being the capital of a country is always an attraction for the tourist, right? But we, the residents of Delhi, we often question ourselves, what is good air in Delhi? There is so much crowd, the heat is so much. I mean, it's that, the scorching heats really kills you, especially in June and July. So we find nothing good in Delhi, right? But for tourists, Delhi is a big attraction point. So here also he says that somebody might not find it, but when you are connected to a place, when you are a native of that place, and when you have spent so many years there, you still have that connection, right? So that is what he is talking about. Please continue.
We have some mango trees in our village. Come visit us and I will give you a raw mango from one of them. Do not eat it. Just take a bite. The soreness is a sure to go straight to your Brahma Rantra. I once took one such fruit home and a chutney was made out of it. All of us ate it. The cough we suffered from after that. I went for the cough medicine that the doctor told me about the special quality of the fruit, Brahma Rantra, the soft part in a child's head where skull bones join later. Here used as an idiomatic expression to convey the extreme potency of soreness. In Sanskrit, Brahma Rantra means the hole of Brahma. It is the dwelling house of the human soul.
Okay. Now, this is yet, the story has not yet started. He's just talking about other things only. Now, here he tells the readers about this special mango trees in the village. See, when we say, what's there in the village life? It's so dull. It's so boring. There are no malls there. There are no movie halls there. We feel so boring there. But still, the nature, the calmness, the peace, the peaceful environment which the villagers have, the life of the villagers is very difficult. They do not live that easy life. Though we people also these days, we are experiencing something of that sort only, where we are restricted in the boundaries of our house. We cannot go anywhere. We have no outings, no excursions, no malls, no movies, nothing at all. We are simply inside our house, right? Even restaurant dining, at this point, everybody is avoiding, right? Even though in Delhi, restaurants have now opened up, still everybody is avoiding because of this pandemic, right? But in villages, all these things are not there. But still, for we city people, if we ever get a chance to visit village, many of you might be having your own houses in villages where your grandparents or great-grandparents or some of the relatives might be living there. So village life is very simple one, but the nature and the environment is beautiful. What we are attracted there towards is the nature, the greenery, which we do not get here in cities. Here we just get that smoke and disturbing sound produced by the traffic. Right? There, all these things are not there. There you, early morning, if you get up there, you will find that natural beauty. You'll be able to see the sunrise. You will find, you know, the big green farms. And you will hear the chirping of the birds. You will hear the cuckoo singing, the peacocks running here and there. So that beautiful flora and fauna, he experienced there in villages. So one such experience he is narrating, where the author is telling about his mango trees in the village, whose mangoes are famous for this special quality, that he once took the fruit at home to make chutney. So he took a few mangoes to make chutney, and everyone suffered from a bad cough after eating it. So after eating that chutney, which was made from that mango, so everyone had bad cough. It was only when he went to see the doctor that he told him about the qualities of mangoes in Hoshali. The doctor told that what qualities of mangoes were there in Hoshali. The narrator asks the readers to take a bite and assures that soreness of the mango will be felt by them till the top of their head, where Brahmandra is located. So Brahmandra is located, is he simply wants to convey that top tak, till the head, you will get that soreness of the fruit, right? It was so sore that he was filled with soreness of the fruit till the top, right? Please continue.
Just as the mango is special, so is everything else around our village. We have a creeper growing in the ever so fine water of the village pond. Its flowers are a feast to behold. Get two leaves from the creeper when you go to the pond for your bath, and you will not have to worry about not having leaves on which to serve the afternoon meal. You will say I am rambling. It is always like that when the subject of our village comes up. But enough. If anyone of you would like to visit us, drop me a line. I will let you know where Hoshali is and what things are like here. The best way of getting to know a place to visit is. Don't you agree?
Okay. Now he is giving some further explanation about his village. Not only the mangoes, everything in and around this village is remarkable. The creeper, he's talking about the creeper plant. Like money plant is a creeper plant. So the creeper growing in the pond and its flowers are also special. He's talking about the creeper plant, which is growing nearby the pond. And he says his flowers are also very